success of his television show and earning $50,000 a week, millions in the bank. His one name recognized all over the world. The Queen of England invited Liberace to London. A command performance in the London Palladium. He arrived on the Queen Mary. Saying, I didn't come here to go unnoticed. And he created quite a stir. A 1, 2, 3. Homosexual could have their career destroyed overnight. Liberace sued the newspaper and the reviewer for libel. Under oath, in a court of law, that he was not a homosexual. He won the case and was awarded $22,400, which he donated to cancer research. Fast forward 3 decades later, after Liberace died of AIDS and the truth about his sexuality came out, the London Daily Mirror sued his estate to recover the $22,000. 5, 6, 7, 8. no laughing matter. This was not just some audience heckler he could brush off by raising a middle finger saying, "How do you like the ring on that one?" No, this was no laughing matter. This named the nightmares publicly that he'd always heard whispered. And most important, it attacked his freedom to work in his profession. After these stinging London reviews and the scandalous court case, which wasn't settled until 1959, 3 years later, Liberace found it extremely difficult to find work. His income plummeted. People stayed away from his shows in droves. Las Vegas dropped him. Television forgot him, and movies scorned him. He went from playing the Cow Palace in San Francisco, the Hollywood Bowl, casinos in Las Vegas, Madison Square Garden in New York, to the community concert series